Yeah, so they're quite badly pitted just along the middle of the seat. So what I'll do is I'll try grinding it out and see how it goes. The oil seals were pretty badly worn, and oil's got down these valves on the stem. And what I'll do now is I'll remove that carbon and seat the valves. Just got some motor oil. Nineteen ninety-six 1200 cc sport. Front cylinder head, valve stem movement, forward to rear, it's very little movement, and side. Double checking, we've got the front cylinder head and we've got the front valve, exhaust valve. Grinding compound and the grinding tool. I got these in the year 2000 and so they're 15 years old already. Applying grease to the top of the valve and the larger end of the tool. Just applying the cutting compound to the back of the valve. Shut the valve. To reapply the cutting compound, just bring the valve off its seat and then put it back on and it'll bring in some new cutting compound. We'll just about do, I think. Okay, front inlet, side to side, forward and backward, side, forward, very little movement. Okay, rear cylinder head. Just make a note that the inlet's got a nice, still got its nice factory finish there on the seat. Unfortunately, you can't really see until you get the grinding compound off. That's good. That's good to go. Still got a few pits in it, but considering how bad it was, I think I've probably got away with it and it'll work. Give you a really first class tip. This is the rear cylinder head. Keep the rear cylinder head and the valves together where you're working, and keep the other one as far away as possible. Okay, rear inlet valve stem movement. There's a tiny bit, not much, forward and back. There's a bit of play, but not much. Okay, so I apply grease to the back. This is dished out, so it's not as easy to get the grinder side on. So I just put a bit of grease on the grinder and the valve, push them together. Once it holds, I just get any grease off the back. I get my cutting compound. Just apply it to the back of the valve. I just turn it towards myself and put the valve down on the seat. Start grinding. As I said before, you really want to clean this up good and proper, because it is a sort of a cutting compound, a metal cutting compound, so very, very abrasive. So just get rid of it all. Get a cleaning solution and just blast it all out. I'd recommend keeping them labelled, and just keep the front and rear cylinder heads and valves separate. Okay, so at this stage I'm going to have a bit of a pack up, and I'll start assembling the head. Okay, valve reassembly. Okay, so I've got one head completely finished. Okay, I'll put these holders in over the valve guides. I'll just dip them in oil. I'll do the intake valve first. Just put a little bit of oil on the stem. Okay, get the valve seal. Okay, so this works a couple of days after the previous work. I just want to point out that after grinding the valve seats, that I've completely cleaned it and got rid of any valve grinding compound. Now what I'm going to do is completely clean the valve stem end of oil, because I have to put a little bit of thin tape around the end before I seat the valve seals. Okay, what I'll do now is just attempt to put the valve seal over the edge, because it's got a lock-in ridge around the top, and that's where the collets, the small holders, lock into. So I just dip the valve in oil. This keeps on unsticking, unfortunately. And let's try and feed it through the top, and the name of the game is to get it down past that ridge without any damage. So that's good. Now I'll remove the sticky tape. Okay, job done. I'm using the bike's gudgeon pin. Oil up the sleeve and just use a soft hammer and just drive it on until it seats, and you should be good to go. Okay, so at this stage the holder's in place, the seal's on, the valve's in place. So I've got the inner spring, outer spring, and the top holder. Put them in place. Okay, so that's the compressor. You put it in, you know, over the head. You turn that down. You wind that and compress the spring. That's you can adjust the width, but make sure it's adjusted to the widest, how wide you need it, and but make sure it won't spread apart. You must wear your safety glasses. I'll say that again for clarity. You must protect your eyes, must wear eye protection. This spring's under incredible pressure, and these little collets will come out like bullets if anything goes wrong. It's a good idea to oil the thread just so that it turns easier. So I'll install the compressor now. So that's sitting over the top of the spring. Turn the handle in. I'll back it off because I think I did the small valve the last time. So I'll back it right off until the handle seats. And that's seated now, and I can start winding it in. Just make sure that the top here, just make sure the top will clear the head. You can see how, if I turn it from that side there around to this side, how there's a lot more room there at the top. You might be able to see the spring being compressed now. Okay, so how you put these holders in is it's a cone shape, and the thin part goes down. But what you do is you put them in, and then you bring them up, and you'll feel them slot around the top groove here, and then you bring the spring, you release the spring onto them. So that is to say that you actually bring them up with your fingers and lock them in, feel them in the groove, and then slowly start to release the spring, but don't get your finger caught in the in this area here. So I'll attempt to demonstrate that now. Okay, so that's one. The other side. You can hear them there. This is actually going to go pretty well, so they're in place, and I'll make sure they're held up as I release the holder. Okay, I can feel the spring going up, and the collets, the holders are in place. So that's gone real well, that one. Yeah, groovy. Okay, same thing again, but with a smaller valve. This is the front head. You want to make sure that your valve stem oil seals are straight. I just recommend knocking it around on the edges. So that edge there, just make sure that it's sitting up straight with the valve stem. You want to be checking around for, bits, leftovers, that should be installed. And also, don't forget the holders. So, just to show you there, demonstrate that. I've got the holder, so you put that on first. Then you put your valve and your seal, and then your springs with the holder on top. So there's two holders, really. There's one on top of the springs, and there's one at the bottom of the springs. Okay, that's it. Now the intake valve. Okay, that is a 2 minute or 3 minute seepage test on the front cylinder, the exhaust valve. Well, remember that that was a little bit pitted, so it's got a good seal now. And that's a wrap for the front head. Three-minute seepage test on the rear head exhaust port.